You're watching Sky News at 7. Now, during the Cold War, it was an iconic symbol of airborne power, a vast flying wing carrying a nuclear weapon. Well, now, 14 years after it last flew, a Vulcan bomber has taken to the skies once again, thanks to a £6 million restoration project. Sky's defence correspondent Jeff Mead reports.
14 years since it last flew, the Vulcan bomber finally emerged from its hangar. Over that time, costs have rocketed, the project's faced ruin. But a confident thumbs up from the cockpit signified troubles were over as Delta Lady turned at the end of the runway. Four Olympus engines throttled up, and at 160 miles an hour, the moment of truth. Would she, wouldn't she? Relief as the big jet climbed for a half-hour debut to check controls, in ideal conditions circling the Leicestershire airfield before a perfect touchdown, giving no clue how long it had been since her veteran crew last piloted a Vulcan.
It hadn't really changed a lot. It was still as active, as eager, and every bit as much fun as it was all those years ago. That's 25 years, almost to the day, since I last flew.
Back in the 60s, the V-bombers carried Britain's nuclear weapons. Most were scrapped when the deterrent role passed to the Royal Navy. It's taken nearly £6 million, half from the lottery, half from donations, to get one airborne again. Some question why spend money on a Cold War relic that burns 40 tonnes of fuel an hour.
What I'm hoping is that this aircraft, rather like Concorde, it's an inspirational aircraft. We desperately need to get more young people into design and engineering in this country. And there's a whole generation that haven't seen it. We're after inspiring the young. It's a beautiful sight. It's a once seen, never forgotten sight.
Celebrations, though deserved, may be short-lived. The enthusiasts given such a grandstand view now have to find £150,000 a month to keep this legend flying.
She won't be on the ground for long, though. More test flights are planned, preparing for her public debut, and no prize for guessing who'll be the star of next spring's air shows. Jeff Mead, Sky News, with the Vulcan at Bruntingthorpe.